Before the video starts, I highly recommend reading official SBPE GitHub page and downloading needed programs such as Notepad and any archive redactor you prefer. Links are in the description. So, I've promised myself that I'm gonna start using my voice in videos when I'm gonna hit 350 subs, and here it is. Use these time warps to find needed info faster. We are starting SBPE installation with downloading zip archive. To download it, open releases and click on zip archive that you need. Then we need to create a folder and extract downloaded archive there. I'll be using 7-zip for that, but you can use any archive redactor you like. Now we need to create a config file. There are a couple of ways to do that. Simply copy config template and rename it into config. Or you can launch SBPE and it will do it automatically. Setting right gamepath is the hardest part of installation. Basically, you need to open your config file with Notepad++ and edit first line of it. Easiest way to do this is to copy it from StarBreak shortcut, if you have it. But if you don't have it, you can do it manually on Find It with Steam. Open library, StarBreak properties, local files, browse local files. Note how I keep mvmo client.exe at the end. Also, don't forget to save the file. Now we delete an bug test plugin which Atomizer left by mistake. Now we just wait till mipmaps are generated. That's pretty much it. Congratulations on finishing SBPE installation part. If you've tried, you know that you can't pin bat files into desk hotbar. But there is a simple way how to avoid this. Create a shortcut to your run, then add a cmd/c and take your path into quotes. Set the wanted icon. And rename. All of these advantages aren't that needed, but it's a fair price for waiting additional 1 second while launching. Now second part of this video starts, editing SBPE. Yet again, I recommend visiting official SBPE GitHub page for additional info. All of the shown after keybinds triggers will be in the description as a text line, feel free to copy them if you want. In Zoom you change these numbers to change how much you zoom out and in from your native resolution. You can put any case as a triggers, especially valuable info for those who don't have Notepad on their keyboards. Second most used keybind is areas and monsters HPs. A useful trick is a turret checking, which allows you to check how many turrets dropship has before starting it. Hiding all shells is rarely but still used, could be very useful for making some clips or streaming. But note that you need to make some simple editing on noise plugin, otherwise it will look like this in your game. Just add hashtags so it will look like this. Hitboxes allow you to see hitboxes, could be very useful sometimes. High chat is a good tire keybind and basically the only reason I recommend you updating to new SBPE version. Now about changing colors of most commonly needed things, starting from hitbar. You can find link to this site in the description. To change size and color of users, you need to open extra info plugin and simply change the color. Note how I don't touch 0x before the color. It's really important. We can do the same with next line. Changing this line affects location name. Thanks for watching. Drop a like, send this video to your friends that have problems with SBPE, and see you in the next video.